Hello and welcome back to my channel, and this video is gonna be a little bit different. Hi Marines, I'm just giving a lecture of my own two cents, which is not for you. Stay in business. So, as I said before, I was rudely interrupted by the Marines, I saved myself. The question is, what do you do when you finish Halo? And by finishing Halo, I don't mean by just finishing the campaign. I'm talking cleaning out the whole map, every FOB, every stranded soldier, every target of interest, including the one all the way down here. What do you do? And I must say, there are some things you can do. So let's take a look at some of them that might be quite interesting. Let's go. Number one, go through your vehicles. If you did it correctly, you should have quite a collection, and you should also get the Wasp. Now, Wasp is obviously a much better alternative to a Banshee because you don't have to collateral damage, I guess? Anyway, you can get the Wasp. What can you do with the Wasp? You can fly around. Not only you can fly around, you can actually go and look for Banshees. And that is number one most favorite thing to do. So how does Banshee hunt look like? You basically come around this area, which is FOB hotels, so basically the bottom of the map. As you can see, there's a Banshee. So that means this is the Banshee spawning area, which basically means there should be some Banshees usually flying around trying to ruin your day. If there's no Banshees, they will show up. So you can hunt Banshees. And see how elites are falling down to their death. Oh, there's another one. But you get the idea. Let's go for thing number two. Number two. As small as it looks like, if you've done everything correctly, you should have a lot of weapons, and specifically the modified weapons that you've picked up from your enemies. Obviously, we're only gonna go with something that is very OP, so we're going for the Flex Fire Sniper. And obviously, no assault rifles, but something a bit more interesting, which is also painted yellow for extra kicks. And now, you are absolutely ready to go and explore stuff and drop down into the fights, because surprise, surprise, despite the fact that you've actually cleaned out most of the big FOB bases, the enemies are still there. And they just cannot live without making your life miserable if you somehow manage to land there. So for instance this base, which I have forgotten the name of because, you know, at the end of the day they kind of look the same. You just go and say hello. Hi Wasp. I swear, I didn't kill anyone before I came here. Actually, talking about that, There's actually no one here. Well, you get the idea. Like, you know, just go kill enemies with all the best new guns you have that you wish you had while you were trying to do a campaign. Because these guns are actually OP. Unlike the ones that you actually picked up. Anyway, fail. Let's go for thing number three. Thing number three. Wait, or four. I don't know. One of them. Use your grappling hook to reach places you should not be going. And as much as it sounds funny as hell, traversing these things is fun. Also will help you in multiplayer. If you have a grappling hook cooldown, of course. If you don't, well, then you're not really going to be in a good place anyway. But if you learn this magical skill, well, then I would say life definitely will smile on you. Also, there's nothing more satisfying than just climbing rocks, pulling Master Chief up, because, come on, do you really need to say why? See you at top. And this is what I mean by standing on the top. There's a Banshee. How convenient. I wonder who's guarding it. Also, FYI, you don't have fall damage in this game. At least not for Master Chief. For your enemies, sure. For you, nope. Guess that armor does actually help you a bit. Also, try not to jump out of Banshees or from the cliffs, because as you can see, you're gonna just fall into space. Top tier level design. So before you go down as a cannonball, make sure you're somewhere friendly, which basically means not really exactly above the void. Once you know you're clear, disembark. Trust me, this works. I honestly believe all these enemies are just afraid of you guys. Because usually you can't even walk for 2 minutes without being bothered by the brutes. Oh well, that brings us to the next step. And I would say the most important thing, appreciate how this game looks, specifically if you're able to run it on ultra settings. So when I said there's still enemies, right? There's a bit more to that. As you know, you are able to upgrade your suit using Spartan cores. If you have enough Spartan cores, you guessed it, you can upgrade your armor. How do you get Spartan cores? You collect them in the wild. How do you find them? Here's the fun thing. You stumble upon them. So you might think this is just a regular foreigner artifact or just piece of the ring, right? You see this little tiny opening here? Or it might be a little bit down here. Let's go and explore that. Take a weapon. Grab a Banshee. And just go and take a look. Because if you are just flying around, keep your eyes peeled. You will find things like this. Now, you might think you're completely screwed, but this is where the fun actually begins. You can now actually start exploring. I never said I'm a sniper though, so don't hold it against me. Well, you kind of get the idea. Let's move on. Well, what else we can do? Very simple. All this is a crashed ship. You can explore the ship. It will require a little bit of parkour. That is nothing for someone as skilled as you. In the arts of parkouring, of course. Because I'm kind of bad at it. But I never tried to be good. However, what we need to do is just get up to this ledge and hope we don't miss. So the idea is to get up without falling down. I must say, this is pretty cool. I honestly should just give up at this point, which I'm gonna do. But before you quit, look at the size of this thing. Yep, this is the starting position. To get the idea. Now let's go for the most time-consuming stuff that will give you absolutely nothing. Same as all these tips. See you there. The most useless thing is climbing a beacon. Why? Well, why not? We are already here. So once you are here, you are able to figure out will this energy thing cook you or not. Pro tip, I'm not gonna tell you. Once you do, you can just look at the universe and also probably notice the ship with very low quality things once you zoom in with a sniper rifle and just feel that you've finally beaten Halo Infinite. What you can do next is replay the campaign on Legendary once it's available, and probably in co-op as well. So there you have it, a couple useless things to do Once you finish Halo Infinite. And this is my favorite. Jumping into the universe. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.